Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 134 of Fallout 4. Last episode was, I don't know, Volks the Merchant. Just spent most of the time selling crap to these vendors here. Returned back to Diamond City to talk to Nick, and that's what we're here to do. So let's go say hi to Nick, shall we? This should be, we already started the next quest, but...
Are you here?
Nick?
Uh-oh.
Oh God, it's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
Can we get started on my case?
Oh, of course. There's just a small clerical thing we need to clear up. Here. I know an amount wasn't on the table when you went out to find him, but you deserve a reward. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
So I deserve a reward and something else. Oh, baby! Oh, my.
When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, the devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
My wife was murdered. She was trying to keep them from taking Sean, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers, but they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. What else can you tell me?
We're looking for my son. Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? And why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders. Super mutants, the Gunners, and of course there's the Institute.
Who are the Gunners?
High-end mercenaries. No job too brutal. They're in the running as likely suspects. They wouldn't be the ones pulling the strings.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal, and there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
You're one of them. Why do I feel like this would be me telling him that he's a synth? That's my quick save. I'll see what it says.
Don't lie to me, Nick. You're one of them. They made you.
Yeah, I've heard it all before. You're a freak.
Alright, see, this is why I wish the dialogue mod would work, and I would know what my character says, Bethesda, instead of these generic fucking descriptions. Whatever, we'll continue.
You don't know anything about them? Really?
Some kind of security setting strips or blocks out those memories. And it's not just me. Any synth that gets trashed, left behind, or escapes the Institute has the same problem. Probably some kind of failsafe.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper across your face.
Not much to go on, but a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far in the violence business. What else?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
Who is he? Do you think he has Sean?
It's way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
You said he lives here? He's still in town?
They both vanished a while back, if I'm remembering right. But that house is still there. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
That weird camera glitch there when he got up. Interesting. Is it just me or the back of my head look weird? Like, I guess, is that leather? Okay, now. It looks like, I'm not gonna lie, when a guy was sitting down in the bleachers, from like this distance, I could have sworn, not the bleachers, but the chairs over there by the wall, I could have swore, like, it gave me the back of my head, like, the ghoul skin. I'm like, I'm a ghoul now? But apparently it's just the leather from my helmet. I never noticed that before. Interesting. Oh, and apparently I'm allowed to steal everything in here now.
Yes! Yes!
Bye. You've really gone through a lot, haven't you?
Yes?
Hope you and Nick find that monster.
I will, as soon as I'm done taking all your shit. Ooh. Ooh.
The Marty Bullfinch case. Marty was Nick's partner. Emphasis on the was. He must have been some kind of desperate to come to us for help after all this time.
Oh my goodness, we're just picking up like 14 different quests all of a sudden. Alright, so we'll listen to that audio tape here. Where is that? Inventory, miscellaneous, I don't remember the beginning of the name. What was it? Let's see if I can find it really fast here. I don't know if it was just straight up Marty Bench. Yes. Okay, cool. It's hard to find your tapes in this list sometimes.
Old bucket of bolts, it's Marty. I know it's been a while, but I came across a little mystery I thought might get your circuits firing. You remember that ugly grasshopper statue on top of Faneuil Hall? Turns out it's got a note in it. A note written by the son of one, Shem Drown. I don't expect that name means anything to him, but the guy was a coppersmith. Way back when folks did shit like that. Apparently, this note leads straight to the old guy's stash. I don't know what's in it, but I'd sure like to know if it's still there. I'm gonna go do a little recon on the hall. If you decide you want to get the team back together, you let me know.
Gimme, gimme. The Gilded Grasshopper. Okay, see, I mean, here we're just picking up quests now. I'm okay with this. More shit to do. But, let's find something. Can you reach this container, Curie? I have my doubts. I just want to find a container. I guess we'll use this this thing right here to throw stuff in. A cigarette machine. Gross. So under junk, what's the heaviest thing I have? Obviously the fan, buckets, yep, okay. Fair enough. Glass pitchers times 3, toy cars. Okay, so we're already underweight.
If you see him, tell Marty I say
grab anything useful.
Which 20 caps, you old lech. Also, hi.
Take anything good.
There's another case file there. I didn't pick it up because we were listening to the tape, and I didn't want her to talk. Cut over it.
Check it out.
So once we're done looting this, we'll pick that up and probably have another holotape.
Grab anything useful.
Absolutely. Clipper ship. I just noticed that.
Take anything good.
No, don't pickpocket. Come on.
Grab that.
Okay. Let's see. Do we get another tape?
The Earl Sterling case. Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
No, we didn't get a tape that time, and I hate it. Whenever you loot, and it's just like instantly, does it show up in here, Earl Sterling? Does it show up in here? Sweet. Case notes, because it just kind of like appeared and disappeared really quick. All right, we got some reading to do. Case, Earl Sterling's disappearance. Client, Vadim Bobrov. Another disappearing act to unravel, Earl Sterling, 25-year-old bartender at Dugout Inn. One of the owners, Vadim, it's Vadim. Vadim Brobov? That's a weird name, but okay. Noticed that Earl hadn't been into work for a few days. Security was called in, no investigation, of course. The Institute took him, is the unofficial word about town, like always. Vadim came into my office, half drunk, with a sob story about he and Earl went way back, and that he just can't believe that Earl would get snatched up by the boogeyman. My gut says he is right. Earl didn't have any enemies, at least none that with enough motive to kill the guy. Not living with anyone either, so we'll have to see if Vadim or someone else at the dugout has his keys. I'd rather not have to explain to security why I was picking in the lock to Earl's door if I slip up and get caught in the act. Okay, and then there was the other dude. Let's see if we can do we have a case note for you? Yeah. No, we just have that. It's Marty. We just have a holotape. Okay, then. Unless I missed something, I don't know. See, like, when you pick it up, I got, like, two items at the same time. I don't know if I missed one or not, which kind of bugs me. But I'm sure somebody will yell at me. And then I'll read it. Don't you worry. I'll read it then. So, let's pop a quick save. Everything's been looted in here because we're terrible, terrible people. Listen to that audio log. Started the quest. Alright, let's head back out. See what Nick is doing. He's probably just waiting for us to walk over to the building. Nice car. Nice car. I don't like the lime green, but nice car. Hey, buddy. Why are we walking so slow? We need to blend in. You're a robot. I'm whatever I am.
I didn't want Ellie to hear this, but I think you should know. Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance is bad news. He's more than just a mercenary. He's a professional. Quick, clean, thorough. Has no enemies. Because they're all dead. Except you. 9-1 odds says he's our man. It's more than just you identifying his distinguishing features. The M.O. is all him as well. Leading a small team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later? Not many mercs in the Commonwealth can pull that off.
Kellogg, you dick! I don't think I've been up here. No, I haven't been up here yet. Look at me walking all slow just to kind of fit in with the atmosphere. You gonna say
here
something?
Here we are. Keep an eye out, will you? Let's see if I can get this open.
Alright, anybody comes up here, I'll blow their head off. Is that what you want?
That's one heck of a lock. Got something to hide, Kellogg? Why don't you give it a try?
Oh, fine. Oh, that's right, I have the key. He's over here trying to pick the lock, and I got the key.
Let's take a look around. Kellogg must have left something behind.
Can I steal all the shit? Fuck yeah, I can. Piss off, Kellogg. It's all mine now. Alright, your lamp R belonged to me. Your broom is now mine. What you did with that broom, I don't want
to
know.
Small to you? Figured a guy like Kellogg would think big.
Well, he's poor now, because it's all mine. Anywho, let's drop a couple other things off. Do we have any weapons that we picked up or we left in our inventory? No. She gave me the trench coat and hat, a couple things that are probably pretty heavy. Let me drop a couple of that stuff off there. And do I have anything really heavy in the aid category? I got a bunch of booze, but nothing like overly heavy. Most of the heavy stuff should be right here in the junk, yeah. Okay. Alright, Kiri, you're going to loot that while I investigate.
Yo, psst. What do get that.
You want? Yeah, you start.
Did you check out that desk?
I didn't see anything in the desk yet, unless there's a button, unless there's a button, then as soon as I hop over, there's
check
a fucking button. Getting some Bioshock vibes all of a sudden.
Bring that here.
Something's not right.
Look for grab anything useful.
So before we hit that button,
take anything
let me
good.
See what's upstairs.
Grab that.
Oh, come on, game, look at this. They tell me where it is. That's, oh,
check
come
out.
On, the hand-holding.
Bring that here.
Oh, the hand-holding,
grab
I don't like it.
Useful.
I don't
take
like the games,
good.
Baby, you. I'm capable of
grab
thought.
That. I will attend to this. Get that.
I know they do that just to appeal to the masses, but I'm capable of thought. Alright, what do we got? What else we got up here? A bed. That's cool, I guess. I mean, he's got some corn and duct tape. I don't know what he's doing with corn and duct tape, but I don't really want to know. And handcuffs! And a paddle! This man is, it says cutting board, but I'm treating it as a paddle. This man has got some interesting fetishes. And candles? Alright, Kellogg is like... Kellogg's into some freaky shit. Corn, duct tape, put the corn together, got some handcuffs, Got a paddle. Oh, yep, he's a taker already. He's the catcher. He ain't the pitcher. Oh my God, Kellogg, that's fucked up, bro. That's fucked up, bro. What's it telling you here? Oh, the cutting board wasn't even looking at it. All right, so beyond the button, there doesn't appear to be much else up here. Let's see if the button does. What secret box this unlocks, or if it blows the whole room up.
Well,
all right.
That's one way to hide a room.
What the fuck, Curie? Just teleported in front of me. Any tarps? Okay. Oop. Ooh. Ooh. You're gonna have some things to hold here shortly. Why do you have a mannequin in here?
Now look at this. All of a Merc's favorite things.
I can't knock it over.
Hey, Valentine.
Why don't you search that table? Then we'll compare notes.
No, this is my stuff.
Check out what's on that table.
No! I don't want to steal his fucking shit. I want to steal this shit, but I want to steal Valentine's stuff. Give me all this. Some cigs. Gross. I hate cigs. Gross. Take all that stuff. And Curie. Again, I'm sorry, but, I have 20, but they're only like 0.1. Yeah, that's not going to really do much. Coffee cups will drop a lot of my weight down. Cigarettes were weightless, so I don't know why I did that. Clipboards are pretty light. Coffee pots, and let's just go back by weight. Alright, let's hear that stuff. Cool. Okay, we're underweight. What we got here?
Gwinnett Stout beer, 44 caliber bullets, and cigars. San Francisco Sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own, though.
So he likes revolvers. He likes Gwinnett Stout. And he likes cigars. Cigars smell... Ugh, at least the cigars I've ever smelt... I smell like shit. And again, I am like, I cigarette smoke, gross. I don't know. I like fires, I like burning shit, but I can't stand the smell of cigarettes. No, I'm not gonna talk. I'm going to finish putting shit away. Anywho, do I have like a shit ton of not buff out, but like the stouts have a pound apiece to them, so we can put those away. I figured I had a bunch of like Nuka-Cola. Something like that was weighing me down unnecessarily. Okay, Curie, please. Curie, let me like talk to you. Quit being glitchy. I'm gonna beat you over the head, Curie. It's gonna happen. Curie? I love that quick save we just did. See if that fixes it. Every now and then the game walks out like that. Can I interact now? Nope. Oh, it's not going anywhere. Use dog meat.
Get hit in the head?
Yes.
I can relate.
Any suggestions, Nick?
What about dog meat? Commonwealth mutt like him can track a man's scent for miles. Why don't you go fetch him and let him have a whiff? See if he picks up the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. If you have to face Kellogg on your own, just say so. Besides, you already have plenty of company. Can't all go sniffing through the Commonwealth after one man.
I question how he knew about dog meat. Did I ever tell him? I don't recall.
Any words of wisdom?
If Kellogg really is the one who kidnapped your son, then he's dangerous. But so are you. You don't need to be afraid of him or anything else the Commonwealth throws at you.
I want you with me on this, Nick.
Nice. All right, so that's what we mainly wanted to do. We don't have to necessarily complete this quest yet, but I wanted to get him as a follower to start working on loyalty. Good. Curie, go to Grey Garden.
All right. Let's get that bastard.
You have a potato for
your
a weapon.
Your show from here on out, okay? You say jump, I'll say how high.
Oh, baby. So, Curie, you can go there. You have all my loot. We'll take it from you. However, can I command you right now? No, I can't, but... I might be able to command you.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Grab anything useful.
Good plan.
Nice. So she's going back to Grey Garden. She'll be there when we get there. So she's bringing all of the loot she has, which is a shit ton. And now I have access to his inventory, which is empty, which just let me take all that stuff in one fell swoop. Awesome.
I've been told the Valentine Detective Agency signs are an eyesore. But they sure bring in the business.
Isn't that the whole point? Anyway, let's leave. We will go back to Grey Garden first. Now, interestingly enough, this bastard decided to make me go get dog meat, which is all the way at Sanctuary, which is kind of motivation to... Oh, well, okay. Thank you, based quests. I was going to say, it is motivation to make me go up north, but the game with the hand-holding again has brought dog meat to me. Hey, buddy. I mean, I don't know how you got here or how you knew. I guess you're psychic, but good boy.
Dog meat. Get the scent, boy. Got something, boy?
It's like he barked, but he didn't quite bark. Like I said, game's quirky. So I don't necessarily need to follow him right now. I do kind of want to go to Grey Garden, but... Okay, so that starts a new quest. Dogmeat's not going to go anywhere, which means I don't have to go to Sanctuary just yet. But again, I mean, because what we're doing... is going back up to clear this little... And there's really not much here because this is all open area. To clear that area. Maybe we'll follow him a little bit just to...
Humanity is so resilient to cling to life despite all of this. It is the duty of us all to further that survival.
Bye, Curie. Hey, he's taking me home. I gotta go this way anyway. Thanks, bro. Let's follow him. This is working out. Without any pieces, the power armor frame provides a variety of advantages like increased carry rate, greater melee damage, and the elimination of falling damage. That it does. But I want to deck one out in a shit ton of armor, because why not? But we'll follow Dog Meat for a little bit, and hopefully we don't get off track too far. I don't know what's going to happen with him as like a follower, if it's going to send him back to Sanctuary or what. Hopefully he doesn't glitch out and disappear. Heard of followers doing that quite a few times. I mean, again, I don't want to go too far, Dog Meat. I got to go drop off my inventory. Where are you taking me, buddy? Where are you taking me, man? Make sure nobody's out there. Okay, then. Someone's fighting or screaming over here. Somebody... God damn it, I'm gonna get distracted, aren't I? Oh, come on. Sounds like a tarp. It's got tarp written all over it. Alright, you have fun in there. I have a feeling this is an instance area and you can stay in there forever and the quest will never continue. Or you can just appear in front of me. And disappear. Well then. Do we do it? No. I can't. It's an instance area. It's not going anywhere. I can't do it. Hold on, let's turn the quest off so I can mark my map. Let me go back to the map so I can mark my map correctly. We need to take care of this first. This needs to happen. Place marker. Not to mention, we had that one dude we sent here. I don't remember what his name was. Start with an S? Sheffield? Is that what it was? Start with an S. I think that was his name. And where am I going? Just to make sure. Just straight up across this pond, up north, across the bridge is probably the fastest way. Well, let's get back on it. This I don't recall exploring, so this might be... Might be some enemies or something here, but that's not what I'm interested in. Oh, I remember this place. Hey, buddy. I need to build up some crits. Let me get closer to you. I know bloatflies hurt and all, but, No. Yes, right there. Go for the torso shot. But I need to build some crits after what we did with the shotgun in the face of the one dude. Of course he gets a shot off. I got shot in the butt. You're an ass, Bloodbug. You're an ass. You shot me in the ass, but you're an ass. Can I get... No, that's not a good chance. Let's try this. That's a better chance. I don't want to waste AP while I'm here. Might as well go for a respectable shot. No, he won't underestimate us because he's dead. I'm cool with that. But for now, we need to leave. It's just things are respawning and trying to kill me. That's par for the course. And before ghouls? Ghouls? I know we've been here before. Or by lurch even. This is where we had to go find the kitty. Oh, hello. Festering bloatfly. Alright, I'm not gonna take chances with you because I know what you're capable of doing as a bloatfly. Alright, shoot him right now. I waste a crit because he's gonna grab me. I don't feel like dealing with that. Okay, festering bloatfly. Alright, you're going after Nick. They're so hard to hit outside of bats. And I want to build some crits on you. Stay still. And he's gonna grab me in the face, isn't he? Don't grab me! That's a 70%! Kill it! Kill it! I do that stupid animation and it hurts. So, yeah, the bloat fly that bit me there, or, well, not bit me. Apparently they shoot weird things at you. They hurt. They have always hurt. I don't want to go out on a stick. Where is my Mylar cakes? Where are my Mylar cakes? So that should be good enough. Looks like we're good. Let's make sure we loot. They poison you or whatever, and then it lasts for a while. It's pretty annoying. Bloat flies are very, very strong. Now, where'd that festering bloat fly corpse go, though? I shot him over here with a shotgun. Did he, like, explode and go a mile away? Is this him? Yes, that's him. I'll make sure I get the stuff while I'm here anyway. Alright, so we're healing back up. That's fine and dandy and all. Let's reload our guns. Cool beans. Everything is loaded now. Awesome. Aw, the poor Brahmin named Best. That's just cruel. That's just cruel. Okay, I know I still need to, like, loot these buildings. We only discovered this place because we had to chase the kitty cat down. Because it escaped from Vault 81, and we weren't having that. I guess I'll take a few of those along the way. And if I can find some hub flowers. I know I need those. I know I need those for the chem station. There's a couple recipes that made use of them. More hub flowers is always nice. And hey, did the stuff respawn over here? There's a whole bunch of crops last time. Maybe? Nah, it doesn't look like it. I think I hear something. Am I hearing something out there? That sounds like a bug. The wings fluttering. I don't know if you saw that, but Nick's just kind of phasing through the wall over there.
Sweet.
I don't remember if I went back here last time. I think I may have missed this. I think I may have missed that. What am I? Ah, that's what I was hearing. I knew I was hearing something. It's a chem station, but I have one at home with, you know, the actual stuff that we can use to craft, so I'm not going to take it. Alright, let's give Nick the stuff. Nick has an empty inventory, thank God, so I can just drop in a container and have him insta-pick it up. This is the beauty of having a follower whose inventory isn't completely and utterly full. So, junk, whatever's the heaviest, obviously the fertilizer.
Hey, check it out.
There you go. The plan is, you are a pack mule and you will carry all my garbage. I don't know where you got that rifle, but you're welcome to use it, because it's a piece of poop. It's probably better than the little revolver that you had earlier. You had a pipe revolver. I can't imagine that doing very well in combat. These look like some of those were hub flowers at one point, but nothing on them. Hey, UFO! I miss you, bro! I miss you! I miss you, little alien. We killed him. We killed him dead. Poor guy. And he won't respawn either. No. Oh, the alien. We're pretty damn close. Once we get on the railway, it's just still, I mean, it's just a straight shot there. Won't be too much to explore either. I remember seeing that, though. Got over there. That's the settlement. Again, we'll free that settlement here eventually, but I have all my stuff set up, all my crafting things at Grey Garden, so I need to hit that place up right now. That's kind of become a good hub in the middle, and then there's Starlight to the north of that, and at the very tippy top, there's Sanctuary. Those are all settlements that have been flushed out with all the crafting things. The workstations, I mean, it doesn't really matter what's in the workstations, as long as they're linked. But it has all of the crafting stations, and that's what I need. And both of them, well, all three of them, are pretty damn well defended, so we're good on that front. Look at my floating settlement here, because adding beams is wonky until I add that mod, which, again, I still want to add the improved place in red mod, I forget what it's called, but the game updating as frequently as it has been, even my dialogue mod, still isn't working. So, gotta wait. Alright, we gotta find Curie. Finding her is very important, because she's going to have tons of stuff on her. She should be coming here, but let me drop some things off in here. Oh, this is gonna be good. This is gonna be good once we start getting this shit out of here. Curie, where are you, though? Did you get here? We may have to wait or, like, save and sleep or something to pass time to get her to show up. That's not Curie, I know that. That's what Supervisor White. You're a robot. You're a robot. You wouldn't understand. So I don't see Curie. We did send her to Grey Garden. I am going to sleep in a bed to see if that speeds up things. And hey, look, they're all stacked up. I didn't think they'd even use the beds up there, but they would count towards the settlement, so that's why I did it in the first place. That's awesome. Let's go to 6. Should be good. Well rested. Just waking up and Nick's beside me. It's a little bit creepy. Not sure what he was doing there. And Kiri, have you arrived yet, or should I start panicking? I hope I don't have to start panicking. I have to start panicking at some point. And that's Supervisor White. It's incredibly obvious. That voice. I don't know. Kiri will probably pop up at some point. All the settlers seem to do. It might just take a bit. And sure enough, it, like I said, there she is. Might just take a bit for her to catch up. But guys, it is time to wrap the episode up here. Episode 134. A bunch of story time with Nick, but we did unlock him as a follower, which is excellent. Started another quest that we can continue. I am not sure. Do I want to, for next goal, do I want to go up north? Maybe hit up some of the settlements along the way? And then we'll start exploring. Do I want to continue his quest? I don't think we're going to continue his quest. I think we're going to head up north there and explore. But the question is, do I want to go to all these settlements and pay him a visit? I think that'd be a good idea. It's been a while. It's been a really long while. Kiri's talking to me. But either way, guys, I gotta wrap it up here. Episode 134. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.